Okay.
We are getting back to the spooky. Test, test.
Okay. Let's get back into this.
I was enjoying myself
last
time. I
don't think you understand, Dr. Petrov.
Oh, hello.
No, I understand everything.
I'm telling you now, Doctor, the UAC is taking over this operation.
Operation? Is that what you're calling it?
The situation is out of control.
It's not out of control, Swan. You are. I'll manage
this.
This
Doom is very different.
And you and your flunky will be taking control of nothing. Do you understand?
Yes, Betruger. I think I do understand.
There's a reason I picked this one.
Okay, Plan B.
And that's because it's more spooky than Rip and Terry. Really weird period there. In the early 2000s, they decided we made Doom a horror game.
Formally designated Phase 1 by the Union of...
Oh!
I'm
also a really bad shot.
...and became fully operational July 17, 2130. Originally created as the Prime Science and Research Facility, Alpha Labs are responsible...
And of course, I'm playing it all in the dark. Shotgun shells, I'm very low. Five, eight, six. Thank you, sir. Grenades. Not have a code for that. Safe.
Don't stop, buddy. There's nothing you can do for me. They're all gone.
Access denied.
Surprised us. They just came out of nowhere.
Yes, this is a very different Doom game. Like I said, this is, you know, in the 2000s, whenever they were like, it could be a spooky game. And I mean, I've never finished it all before, so like most of this is blind, and I really don't remember much of it, so this might as well be blind. I don't remember much. Can't go in there. What's the reason I came in here? There did scientists somewhere that I can... Can't do anything with that. Can't go in there. That door won't open. There's nothing over here. Why did I come in here? Is there any reason for me to come in here? There's gotta be something, right? Yeah, it is a lot more like an Alien kind of game. Well, I guess I'm gonna hop back out through this window because I don't know.
There's still a few squads operating, but they're all cut off from each other. Try to find them.
I'll do my best. Let's backtrack a little then. Go in there yet. Don't do that to me, game. Whoa! Died. Thank God. This'll get you a little bit. Not gonna lie. Ow! You fucker. Okay. too harsh on ammo. Okay. And, you know, as per usual, there's not much you need to know about the story. If you didn't watch the last time, some evil doctor opened up the portal to hell for some reason or another. As you do in a Doom game. Yo, what the fuck is that thing? Oh no. Gross. Buy your grenades. Surprisingly, not that hard to kill. Oh, God. Sneak up on me. I heard you, fucker. That did not tell me the passcode. Visit us online. I wanted what was in there. Guess I'll have to wait.
Marine, Bravo team reports there's some sort of unidentified growth taking over parts of the base.
Growth? That's growth.
I don't know what it is, but it can't be good. Stay sharp.
Okay.
Okie dokie then. I heard ya, you fucking shithead. Richie, you're trying to sneak up on me.
It isn't working. I tried everything. The computers aren't responding. I can't get root access to the systems. We can't do it here. We'll have to access the system somewhere else.
All right, let's go.
Some people be acting shady. I don't trust them. Okay. Satan was very upset there.
This is the audio log of Director William Banks, dated October 20th, 2145. It has come to my attention that we have an alarming number of missing personnel throughout the base. My office has received 4 additional reports from Delta in the last week alone, mentioning that personnel are not reporting for work and that calls to their quarters have gone unanswered. My office has sent the names of those personnel to Mars City Security, and they have promised to initiate an investigation. But this news is very disturbing, especially at a time when we have so many people in the infirmary suffering from sudden cases of schizophrenia and other psychological disorders. I hope there is no connection between those cases and these reports of missing personnel.
Seems like wishful thinking.
This is the audio log. This is the audio log of Director William Banks, dated October 5th, 2145. It has been brought to my attention by Environmental Services that the recent power grid changes have caused many non-critical systems to malfunction. The report explains that this is due to either intermittent power outages or lower than optimal voltage input. It also says that sufficient power distribution to all non-critical systems is becoming more difficult to maintain, thanks to Dr. Betruger and his so-called optimizations to the energy stores in and around the facility. I assured the director of ES that I would file a report with Central Authority over this.
Okay.
Welcome to the Alpha.
Ah, hello.
By the Union Aerospace Corporation, the Alpha Labs began construction 29th, 2095, and became fully operational July 17th, 2130. Originally created as the pilot.
Shh.
Instructor, I'd
turn the internet back on.
Access granted.
All right. To the Alpha Labs.
Marine, I've received a report that you haven't reached Bravo Team yet. You need to pick up the pace. Can't wait for you. Reaching the communication facility quickly is imperative.
Dude. Have you seen this place? God, there's so many!
The UAC takes pride in its safety record. Please follow UAC procedures.
Yeah, you're doing a real good job with safety, friends. First and foremost, gotta tell you that. Spookums. I don't like this place.
For generations, humankind has lived under the looming natural resources. Our new ventures on planets like Mars have only intensified our need to find fresh sources for metals, petrochemicals, food, water, and even air. To meet that need, UAC researchers have developed dramatic solutions. Solutions that will soon pay off for the UAC, its investors, and indeed the entire human race. Mars itself is our chief ally and the key to our solution. Look around at its vast red deserts, rich in naturally occurring iron oxides. They are the raw materials of our future. We have developed a process that destabilizes the atomic structure of pulverized iron oxide and separates it into subatomic particles, which are then siphoned off to create new elements. Like alchemists of old, the Elemental Phase Deconstructor allows us to transform red Martian soil into clean air, fresh water, and hydrogen fuel, the building blocks for a sustainable, human-friendly Martian environment. And this is only the beginning. With continued research, we envision creating ever more complex molecules, even organic matter itself. Atom by atom, the UAC is building an ever brighter future for humankind.
You know, I don't like the sound of that. And I'd hazard a guess that something went wrong. Happening. I don't like it. Can't see what's happening. Oh god. Jesus. Nope, don't like that. Like anything that was happening there. Ah, go there. Fuck, man.
Warning. EPD laser active.
Don't stand in that. It'll hurt. Got it. The shotgun reload sound is satisfying. Oh, yeah.
Marine, I've received a report that you haven't reached Bravo Team yet. You need to pick up the pace.
Fuck. Gotta do all this again.
Reaching the communication facility quickly is imperative.
UAC takes pride in its safety record. Please follow UAC procedures.
Oh god.
Our new ventures on planets like Mars have only intensified our need to find fresh sources for minerals, for chemicals, and even air. To meet that need, UAC researchers have developed dramatic solutions. Solutions that will see the cost of the UAC investment.
Warning, EPD laser active.
Ow. Forgot you guys there. Assholes. Can I turn this off? There's probably something good in there.
Audio log for Kyle Berger, research supervisor for the EPD project. The elemental phase deconstructor is fully operational, and the research data we have gathered so far is very impressive. Unfortunately, we had a terrible accident last week. Research assistant Patterson was calibrating one of the quark emitters in the chamber, and witnesses say he appeared to see something. It's almost like something was talking to him, and he backed right into the particle beam. It was not a pretty sight, as it took off the backside of his head. He lived a few minutes, although I'm not sure you could consider that living, but they say his eyes rolled back and forth, and he was trying to talk, although after losing that much brain matter, I'm sure it was just reflex actions. Anyway, due to this, I have enacted new safety protocols in the lab, and we have stocked one of the storage cabinets with emergency medical supplies. The code for the cabinet is 752. End of log.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Now I'm going to save now. Save now. In case this laser fucks my day.
Help me.
Okay, so I can duck there and be safe. Oh. Ah! Made it. Oh god, blind can't see. Laughing's bad. Well, we're not going that way. Can tell you that one. Okay.
Gas leak stopped. Fire extinguished.
Good. Never mind, I guess we are going that way. I thought I hopped down there. I didn't even see that ladder. Oh. Don't scare me like that, game. Oh. What the fuck? Hold on a sec. Back up! Back up! Like that! No, don't like that! What? Whoop. Motherfuckers, quick! That it? You done here? What about you? Those things were freaky looking. Alright, I guess we're going down. This game is very dark. Oh, thank you, autosave. Okay. I need a drink. I definitely think I picked a good one here. It's a lot spookier than I remember. Oh, hey! Saw you up there. Where'd you go? Ow. Shithead. That was cheap. That was cheap. Come on. Fuck. Yeah, that was that jump scare got me good. Yeah, that's why I picked it for spooky games, because I remember it being significantly spookier than the other Doom games. Oh, I don't like this. What's happening? That was also cheap, but your guys, those guys aren't as scary. Oh, hi. Oh, hi. Back up. What's that? Some guys just explode in this, too. Oh, hi! Fuck. Oh, can I? No, can I? No. So I gotta go the other way. If someone walking around that's not me. Claudio asked last night, he goes, why did you call your stream, the Black Sheep? And I said, what other fucking Doom game do you know that looks like this? I don't remember a whole lot of people really liking this game whenever it came out.
Yeah.
And you know,
oh, startled me.
Oh, Jesus
Man,
Christ,
I'm ever
buddy.
Glad to see you. I thought I was all alone. It's been freaking spooky lately. The Hydrogon's blown a few circuits and is unstable. Be careful of that gun. A stray bullet into the glass shields could blow the whole area. I'm gonna try and get this thing stabilized. I'll head to the science office when I have this under control.
You do that. Be careful not to get you! Eviscerated by demons. It's very different from how Doom was usually known. I think it's a fine horror game, but it is distinctively not Doom. So kind of one of those. It's a good game by itself, but not a good Doom game kind of thing, you know? Accidentally pulling out the grenades whenever I want to pull out the shotgun by pushing the wrong button. That sure is a thing that I love to do. Not today, fucker.
Unveiled its development of the Hydrocon. Though still in its prototype stages, will, in one dramatic move, forever end all shortages of water and fuel. By splitting iron oxide molecules, the Hydrocon produces oxygen and hydrogen cheaply and safely, without the need for large amounts of electricity. The hydrogen is then used for hydrogen fuel, a substance so versatile and clean that it can be used in everything from home appliances to today's most demanding rocket engines. A side benefit of producing this fuel is an endless supply of pure, spring-like water that is more refined than any earthbound spring. We envision a world where technologies such as the Hydrocon can be used to end drought and civil strife in impoverished nations where water or fuel have ever been in short supply. While always at the forefront of scientific research and development, Union Aerospace hopes that the creation of the Hydrocon will continue to make safer worlds for everyone.
I sure do love talking about safer worlds, but you know, the world's not exactly safer right now. Where am I getting shot from? Ha 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 ha! The fuck did you assholes come from? Jesus. Back this way for a second. Where's that health? Oh, there's the other side of that rubble. There it is. Got fucked up back there, Jesus Christ. Guns are loaded. Okay. You guys are unpleasant. There's so many. Jesus. Oh, hello, cat. Come to help me out since you heard me screaming? Meow. I appreciate it. Don't bat the microphone with your tail. Yeah, it's almost like they knew that I would need that medkit. Funny how that works.
Here at the UAC, we make a better
Whoa! Can I get a super shotgun? They love hiding stuff in this game, in little corners.
Hello, is this reaching anyone? I'm broadcasting on a very low frequency. If you can hear me, I'm not far.
Please help me.
I've locked myself in storage room C4. Please, if anyone can hear me, please help me.
You know, I can! Slim Jim. fun and games till those freaky hoppy ones come out. Stop eating that guy. And you stop getting eaten. Let's listen to some more lore.
Audio report regarding the disrespectful treatment of new research staff. September 14th, 2145. As you know, I have gone to considerable effort to recruit my staff researchers for Alpha Labs. Finding team members with the qualifications, let alone the willingness to come to Mars, has not been a trivial task. You know this already. But it is necessary that I emphasize why their complaints must be taken seriously. We won't be able to keep our people or recruit new researchers if the harassment continues. No, harassment is exactly the right word. I'm routinely getting reports of UAC security asking inappropriate questions and submitting my staff to unnecessary background checks. I must insist that we be allowed to keep our personal lives private and be left to complete our assignments without further delays. If there is some kind of security threat, I suggest that UAC security look more deeply into their own staff. This is Andrew Chin, end.
That'd be me. There's something specifically that I'm looking for? Engineering. What you doing, Doc? Oh, hello. Die. Man, this is spooky. Oh, I can't breathe.
Since the dawn of the space age, Union Aerospace has been at the forefront of not only developing new technology, but pushing those developments to even more daring extremes. With an abundant production of hydrogen fuel, thanks to Hydrocon, the specialist teams ask the big question: Can we devise a way to store and deliver that fuel to make the dream of deep space research a reality? The answer has been a resounding yes. Under the direction of Dr. Malcolm Betruger, key UAC scientists have made startling new discoveries in the fields of quantum physics. And with them, they have been able to use the actual space between electrons and protons in a molecule as a storage medium for fuel in our interplanetary antimatter drives. Now, fuel that would once take up half the payload of an interplanetary ship only occupies a fraction of that space. You are looking at the Molecular Fuel Storage Compactor. The MFS compressor is yet another UAC marvel that brings the dream of reaching and colonizing the most distant planets closer to a reality. The UAC has long made safer worlds for everyone, and now they will bring those worlds even closer than you could ever imagine.
$10 says that guy's the reason why there's demons. Motherfucker was downright sketchy looking.
Reports they've located your position but are unable to move to your current location. Head through engineering and try to link up with them in Sector 3.
They're gonna all be dead as soon as I get there. Scares. Oh God, where? Oh God, I'm stuck. Out every so often.
Don't shoot. I can help you. The lights are all out. I'll lead you through here if you can get me off this base. Come on, I can't wait. Electromagnetic pulses have knocked out the electrical systems in this area. Watch out, a big one could knock out our lights. There's one.
Oh, I don't like this. It was nice meeting you, sir, but you are so dead.
Stay close.
shit. Man, I don't like this at all. Fuck out of there. Fuck that. Is that new? Oh yeah, your little face huggers. Oh god. Hurry up and reload! Holy fuck! Where's the ladder? Let me up. Fuck those things. Jesus Christ. Needs health very badly. Ow. Okay, that's a little better. Fuck. No more, please. All the health.
Warning. Toxins present. Please execute cleanup procedure.
Okay. How do I do that? Well, I didn't expect to be playing the crane game in this. Okay, that's like perfect. Now, what do I do with it? Oh, I can just push the button that says transfer right into incinerator! That wasn't cool.
Toxic gas levels decreased 50%. Thank you.
Beautiful. Transfer to the incinerator. Burn it.
Toxic gas is cleared. Waste disposal area now safe for entry.
Marine, we gotta pick up the pace. We got more men down. Bravo team is barely.
Death is coming. Actually, wait, I got Lore in here.
This is Operations Coordinator Mark Lamia, dated November 1st, 2145. I am filing this report because I am frustrated beyond belief by the level of incompetency I have to deal with here. I don't know where HR is getting the new employees, but the last five guys they've sent me were all a bunch of idiots. They can't get any of their work done on time. I constantly have to keep an eye on them. They work slow, they don't follow any of the standard operating procedures, and they can't even remember basic things that I tell them. For example, I changed the cabinet door codes here to 123 because I thought that was easy enough to remember, but they still forgot. I don't understand why HR can't get me better people. I'm requesting full authority to hire and fire my own employees. Only way I can run my department smoothly. End of log.
There a cabinet around here? Oh, fuck. Fuck you guys, man. Thank God. damn it. At least now maybe I won't lose so much health in this encounter. About that guy, though, and it almost cost me. Tough. A thousand of those little fuckers come out. Oh, hey! Scared the shit out of me, Daddy. Oh God, come on. Health somewhere, please. Oh, thank God. Okay. Up. Down. Fuck. have to play this incredibly smart. Fast. Tonight, guys. Tomorrow, I might do some more Tales tomorrow. I don't know for sure. But I wanna. I'm not gonna play spooky stuff every night in October. I wanna get back to some Tales. So I'll probably play some of it tomorrow. And from there, I think I'll play it by ear. I don't know for sure. I definitely want to go back to Evil Within and finish that. Get at least two spooky games done, this and that. I'll be happy for spooky month. Anyways. Till next time, take care. Appreciate you coming out. And I'll see you next stream.